come to the next problem. What is the problem? An organic compound A, which has a characteristic odor on treatment with alkali sodium hydroxide, form two compound B and C. And compound A, when treated with alkali, it form two compound B and C. Treatment with sodium hydroxide form two compound B and C. Compound B has a molecular formula C7H8O. It is clear that it is an aromatic compound. And another that is given, which on oxidation gives back a B on oxidation. B on oxidation gives compound A. And the compound C is the sodium salt of acid. Given that sodium salt of acid, and sodium salt of acid when heated with soda lime, when it is heated with soda lime undergoes a decarboxylation reaction. When heated with soda lime, give an aromatic compound D. D is an aromatic compound. So from this formula, it is clear that the B is C6H5CH2OH, that is benzyl alcohol, and it is a sodium salt of an acid, and that is given that this compound B on oxidation gives A, that means benzyl alcohol on oxidation it gives benzaldehyde C6H5CHO benzaldehyde. So it is clear that it is a chemical reaction. Benzaldehyde when treated with concentrated alkali, it is called benzyl alcohol and sodium benzoate C6H5COONA, sodium benzoate. And according to the data, when sodium benzoate heated with soda lime, sodium benzoate when heated with soda lime, it gives benzene, undergoes a decarboxylation reaction to give benzene. Hence, here clear that A is known as benzaldehyde, B is known as benzyl alcohol, C is known as sodium benzoate, sodium salt of acid and sodium benzoate, and D is known as benzene. Move to next one. What is the next question? An organic compound A having formula C3H4, CnH2n-2. So A is at the Y end, that is a propyne. CH3, C, CH3 is A, propyne. On hydration in presence of sulfuric acid and mercuric sulfate, means add water in presence of H+ and mercuric sulfate. So mercuric oxide will follow. What is the product? CH3, COH, CH2. Then rearrangement. What is the product? Acetone is formed. The compound A is A propyne. On hydration in presence of sulfuric acid and mercuric sulfate, give compound B. It is B. Formula C3H6O. Verify. Compound B gives white crystalline product D. This acetone, the acetone, when treated with compound B gives white crystalline product D with sodium hydrogen sulfide. NaHSO3. What is the product? Product is a white crystalline addition product is formed, is known as D. Acetone sodium bisulfite, it is D. So it gives negative tolerance. This one gives negative tolerance, ketone not gives tolerance test, and a positive hydrocarbon as it is methyl ketone is there, it and it gives a positive hydrocarbon test. Again, on dashed on oxidizer, that is a P. On dashed oxidizer, the P gives compound C. When ketone undergoes oxidation in dashed condition, it gives acetic acid plus, it gives compound C. Having formula C2H4O2, very high. Other way to formic acid, HCOOH. So, from this discussion, it is clear that A is propyl, B is acetone, and product white crystalline, B gives white crystalline addition product. B is known as acetone sodium bisulfite. And C is known as acetic acid. Move to next one. What is the next question? An organic compound A with molecular formula C8H8O gives positive DNP test. Dinitrophenyl hydrazine means it is a carbonyl compound. From this it is clear that it is a carbonyl compound. It gives positive DNP test and also positive iodine test. So it is a carbonyl compound. Again, it does not reduce tolerance.
Compound B gives positive Kelly test, means
is aldehyde, and only one aldehyde is in the of that, and that is the B acetaldehyde. And also it reacts with the iodine, that means NiNiO solution, that means it will respond to iodine test. Compound C does not give ferric test. Compound C does not, so it is not aldehyde. And also for iodine, does not respond to ferric test, but for iodine, so it is known as a methyl ketone. C is known as a methyl ketone. That means that is given that it is an alkene, 5 carbon is there, and here one part is 2 carbon is there. So a methyl ketone having 3 carbon, obviously it is acetone. This methyl ketone is acetone. So it is clear that B is acetaldehyde and C is methyl ketone. So by joining this one, we have to prepare A. That means expected formula of A is CH3. Formula it is A, it is known as 2-methyl-2-butene. It is the A. B is known as acetaldehyde and C is known as acetone. And question is there, write the reaction of ozonolysis. We have to write the reaction of ozonolysis. That is CH3, CH, double bond C, CH3, CH3, ozonolysis. What is the product? CH3, CH, CH3. Ozonide is there, hydrolysis in presence of zinc dust, bond break here, resulting in the formation of CH3CHO plus CH3CH3CO. It is A. On ozonolysis it gives B and it is C. And also iodine test from B or C. That means another one is there, CH3CHO, when it is iodine in presence of alkali, it gives LO solid. So here the conclusion is that here A is known as 2-methyl-2-butene, B is known as acetaldehyde, and C is known as acetone.